With Wi-Fi 7 and 6E, I'm getting over a gig and a half on Wi-Fi on my iPhone. I recently upgraded my home internet to 2 gigs up and down, and while I'm getting over that on Ethernet, I wanted to try and get close to those speeds on Wi-Fi. Well, Eero sent me the new Eero 7 Max, and while Apple devices don't necessarily support Wi-Fi 7 just yet, Wi-Fi 6E can get over that gig and a half speeds, and I'm getting those speeds on my iPhone 15 Pro Max, my iPad Pro with M2, and even when I'm several rooms away from the main gateway, I'm still getting over a gig on Wi-Fi. The Eero Max 7 is the latest solution from Amazon, and it is the ultimate future-proofing for your Wi-Fi network. I even placed one outside across a cinder block wall, and I was still getting multi-hundred megabits down and up from that mesh access point for the Eero 7. Now, I know that there are actually no Apple devices that support Wi-Fi 7 right now, but those that support 6E can take advantage of these faster speeds. And I'll get into all the details about Wi-Fi 6E and 7 in just a minute. Let's talk about the hardware of the Eero Max 7. These are $600 per access point, and a 3-pack edges towards $1,700, so these are not inexpensive, but you are definitely future-proofing. Wi-Fi 7 hasn't even gone through all the certifications even as I record this video. But each one of these Eero access points actually has two 10 gigabit Ethernet ports and two 2.5 gigabit Ethernet ports, plus a USB-C for power. They're a little taller and wider than a big HomePod if you have one of those for scale. And unfortunately, there's no mounting options for putting it on the ceiling or power over Ethernet, which I'll get to in a second. But Eero says these can support up to 9.4 gigabits down and up via wired and 4.3 gigabits over wireless. And from what I've experienced, the speeds I'm getting with the Eero Max 7 are just incredible. And I'll be honest, it's just kind of fun to run speed tests every once in a while and see over a gig speeds over Wi-Fi. The Eero Max 7 also has Thread, supports Matter, and even Zigbee. Unfortunately, there's no HomeKit support right now. Now, when it comes to setup, the Eero setup is just undefeated. It is super simple, both to set up the main gateway and the remote or satellite access points. Right now, I have one hardwired to Ethernet here in the studio, then the two other access points are actually remote, not connected to Ethernet at all. They just have power, and they're operating on that true mesh network that Eero does. Now, if you didn't know, Eero is owned by Amazon, so when you set them up, you can log in with your Amazon account or create a new account from scratch. Now, once I set it all up, I tested in each location. Now, here in the studio, when I'm right up against the Eero Max 7 that's hardwired to Ethernet, I put it in the 10 gigabit port. When I run a speed test, both on my iPhone 15 Pro Max and my M2 iPad Pro, I'm getting over a gig speed, sometimes close to a gig. I actually found that my iPhone 15 Pro Max got faster speeds more consistently than my iPad. Now, if I compare this to an Apple device that only has Wi-Fi 6, like my M1 Pro MacBook Pro, you see there's a significant difference even when it's connected to the same network. For my second test, I went a couple rooms away. It's about 40 feet away from the main gateway Eero Max 7. That satellite is not connected to Ethernet, it's just with the true mesh, and I was still getting over gig speeds on my iPhone 15 Pro Max a couple rooms away. Then I also went outside, ran another test, and this is through a cinder block wall, but even being outside, I was getting multi-hundred megabit down. I'll get into the details of Wi-Fi 6 versus 6E versus 7 in a second, but if you're wondering what Apple devices can actually take advantage of these speeds, I'll put a link to this Apple support document in the video description. Basically, if you have a MacBook Pro that was made in 2023, that would be the M2 or M3 MacBook Pros, a Mac Mini or Mac Studio, or Mac Pro from 2023, the latest iPhone models, Pro or Pro Max, not the regular iPhone 15, and an iPad Pro with an M2 chip, then you could take advantage of Wi-Fi 6E speeds. Now, like I said, getting the Eero Max 7 is future-proofing. I don't know when Apple is going to add Wi-Fi 7 to their devices. Because it's not even certified yet, we might not see it in the iPhone 16. It might be a year and a half away. But again, getting a Wi-Fi 7 router is future-proofing your entire setup for years to come. And because it can support up to 4.5 gigs on wireless, honestly, your internet service provider is probably gonna be the bottleneck for internet speeds in the future if you have this kind of setup. So let's talk about Wi-Fi 6 versus 6E versus 7. I'll put a link to this Tom's Hardware article in the video description as well. They have a great breakdown of the three. But the big difference between 6 and 6E, like on your Apple devices, is the addition of the 6 gigahertz spectrum for the Wi-Fi network. When it comes to these wireless bands, the higher the number, the faster the speeds can actually get to your device, but the less they can travel through walls or go greater distances. So Wi-Fi 6E, like on your Apple devices, added the capability for that 6 gigahertz wireless band. That's why it's faster. Now, Wi-Fi 7 doesn't add another band. It's 2.4, 5, and 6, but the max channel bandwidth, it basically doubles on Wi-Fi 7, and the maximum spatial streams also doubles to 16. Maximum bandwidth per stream also doubles here. So Wi-Fi 7 is just going to have way more throughput through those wireless streams and across these bands when it finally comes to your devices. Now, there are plenty of Wi-Fi 6E routers on the market today, and they're much cheaper than Wi-Fi 7, and that will take full advantage of the Wi-Fi 6E on your Apple devices. But if you're building a new home or looking to future-proof your setup, then you're pretty much going to be good on Wi-Fi for years to come. And I have to say, I've set up Eero systems for multiple people. It's honestly my go-to when I know it's someone that maybe not as technically savvy, but they just need an easy Wi-Fi setup that's rock solid, they never have to think about. Eero is one of the best options for that simplicity of setup and just rock solid performance. So should you upgrade to a Wi-Fi 7 network right now? Because we're super early in that technology cycle, it's gonna be the most expensive now than it ever will be in the future. Like I said, one Eero Max 7 is $600, and if you wanna get a 3-point setup for larger homes with that true mesh, it's gonna be about $1,700, $1,800 after tax here in the US. I'll put links to those down in the video description, and if you want to buy it, I encourage you to use those links. They're affiliate links, I'll be honest. But you should consider a few things. Number one is, what is your actual internet speed from your internet service provider? I'm lucky enough here to have fiber that actually has up to 5 gigabit plans that I can get. And my Unifi system, which I'll talk about in a second, can support up to 10 gigabit speeds to my Wi-Fi routers and other devices on Ethernet. Now, if you have a cable internet provider and your upload speed maxes out at 20 megabits, getting a Wi-Fi 7 system is probably not worth it right now. But if you have a gig, 2 gig, or more from your internet service provider, that's step one. Step two is the equipment that has to go in between your internet service provider and your Wi-Fi routers and other devices. I've had a Unifi Dream Machine SE for the past year and a half, and I absolutely love that device. But as I upgraded my internet to 2 gigs, I realized that the 8 ports only support 1 gig service, and I needed to get another switch, go from that SFP Plus port into a switch that supports 2.5 gigs on all those Ethernet cables, and then I went from there to my Eero 7 Max and my Mac Studio. If you want to learn more about Ethernet speeds and Apple devices, check out the video above where I talk about my 2 gigabit internet upgrade. But all these pieces of hardware can get expensive, so if you have to upgrade all of that part of your network, that plays into the cost of your Wi-Fi as well. And number three, you have to consider where you're going to put these access points and how you're going to set up your home in general. When we built this house, I planned to do power over Ethernet access points from Unifi. I bought the Wi-Fi 6 long range because that was one of the best that was available at the time, and I mounted them to the ceiling of the home. I love the ceiling mounted Wi-Fi access points, provides great coverage, they're out of the way, I don't have to have them on a shelf, and they're power over Ethernet, meaning I don't have to run electricity or an outlet. So if you have the ISP and the back end of switches all to support up to 10 gigabit speeds, and you want the best Wi-Fi possible, the Eero Max 7 is the one to get. The speeds even over that mesh network are incredible, and I love that you get that many Ethernet ports on each access point. Here in my studio, I can actually go to my Mac Studio, to my Blackmagic ATEM switcher, all from that one Eero access point. But what am I going to do personally? Well, I have to say it is very tempting to lean on the Eero Max 7, because as I go back to my Unifi system and Wi-Fi 6 access points, I'm not getting anywhere near these speeds on Wi-Fi. It's usually around 100, maybe if I'm lucky 200 megs, especially if I'm a room away. But I really like power over Ethernet, mounting my access points on the ceiling, and if I really wanted to get these speeds with my current setup on Unifi, I could get the new Enterprise Wi-Fi 6E access points. They're about $280 each, I have two in my home, and I could replace both of those. It's just not future-proof to Wi-Fi 7. So if you like to be on the bleeding edge, never think about your Wi-Fi again for probably the next 5 or more years, the Eero Max 7 is an incredible option. The setup is super easy. It's going to be the fastest speeds you can get probably from your ISP for years to come. And the hardware is just really useful, especially if you have multiple Ethernet devices. Again, I'll put links to the Eero Max 7 down in the description. If you have any questions about my setup or something I didn't cover, leave a comment below this video. I'd love to hear from you. And subscribe to the channel, hit that like button. And if you'd like to see more about my home internet upgrade and the whole Unifi system, check out this video above here. And if you want to learn about all these smart home and HomeKit devices I have here, I have a video with my 100 plus Apple HomeKit devices. You can check that video out right here. Thanks for tuning in. I'll catch you next time.